It's interesting. The host of the Benny Johnson Show asked Kamala Harris supporters at the DNC convention in Chicago why they're supporting her. Many of them struggled to actually answer.
Trump or Kamala, what do you think? Trump or Kamala Harris?
Oh, God, it's Kamala, definitely.
Yes?
1,000%.
Yes?
Yeah, absolutely.
What's your favorite thing Kamala's done in the last 4 years?
Honestly?
Yeah.
Actually, don't use this.
Oh, Kamala.
Kamala Harris.
Yeah, Kamala.
Kamala, why?
Well, she's... Honestly, I don't know.
Okay, well, I'm not gonna lie, I'm not super knowledgeable, so I can't really speak too much on it.
Because Trump sucks.
Yeah, pretty much same thing.
It says so much, doesn't it? So many people are just getting swept up in the hype, the campaign, and the BS. They don't even know why they like her.
Well, it's funny because if you have no policies, then how could you say you possibly support her? If you go online, here's the thing. No one likes Kamala. No one liked Joe Biden. They simply hate Trump. The difference is you could ask the dumbest Trump supporters on the street, and they would probably at least give you 1 to 5 policies or things he's done that they like, at least a direction he's going. These are truly the most low IQ voters. They are only voting for her because she's not Trump. And the sad thing is with the interviews, you're basically admitting that. And let's be real, the country, and they managed to destroy the country in 3.5 years, so I'm not sure what policy she's great. When she's talking about the price gouging and all these things, she literally is talking about communism. They're telling you to your face. She's not even able to do these things, but that is the direction they want to go. Mm-hmm. These people are socialists and they love communism.
Yeah. A recent CBS News poll shows that Kamala Harris is leading Donald Trump by 12 points among female voters, 56 to 44, compared to Joe Biden's 6-point lead in July at 49% to 43%. Emily, why are women flocking to support Kamala Harris? Is it because she is a woman, because she hasn't done any interviews, so she can't actually reveal what she's like? Or is it because she's a Democrat and we're edging closer to polling day?
Well, when you look at polls, you see that the group that votes the most left and is usually the most mentally ill and uninformed is single liberal women in America. So of course they're all voting for her because they've been brainwashed and fed, you know, fed Trump is bad and he's taking away women's rights, which is crazy. Trump has said he's not doing a nationwide abortion ban. He wants to protect IVF. He also wants to protect women from dangerous people coming into our country. And he also wants to keep men out of women's sports, but it's mm-hmm. they're so brainwashed. They completely ignore all of that. And they're like, she's a woman. And I'm like, you know what? If you want a woman to be president, personally, I don't care. I don't think that's the most fitting role for a woman, but if that's what you want, how about an intelligent woman? If she's the president, she would put women back 50 plus years at least. I mean, it's embarrassing. She truly is an embarrassment. I don't trust the polls in general, but I do know that is why women are voting for her.
It's embarrassing, and it's embarrassing to watch all the women getting swept up in it just because she's a woman. Maybe we could look at her policies. Oh, there aren't any available. Look, it looks like RFK Jr. will be dropping out of the race and will be throwing his support behind Donald Trump. This is what his running mate, Nicole Shanahan, had to say.
There's two options that we're looking at, and one is staying in, forming that new party, but we run the risk of a Kamala Harris and Walt's presidency because we draw votes from Trump, or we draw somehow more votes from Trump. Or we walk away right now and join forces with Donald Trump.
And Donald Trump says he's open to it.
Can I ask you about RFK? Because just moments ago, his running mate said that they were considering endorsing you. Have you considered him for a role in the administration, and what role would that be?
Well, we haven't, but I would love that endorsement because I've always liked him.
Would you also consider putting him in the administration?
You're asking me a very unusual question. I haven't been asked that question yet. I like him a lot. I respect him a lot. I probably would if something like that would happen. He's a very different kind of a guy, a very smart guy. And, yeah, I would be honored by that endorsement, certainly.
Emily, I want to get your thoughts on what this will do to Trump's chances, I guess, but also what it says about the Democrats.
Yeah, well, what it says about the Democrats is even traditionally libertarian people, and I consider myself middle on most subjects, have strayed from this party because this party is insane. This went from the party that was anti-war. This administration has brought us into multiple wars, which we all believe under Trump would have never happened, which is ironic because these people still are protesting the wars, yet they want to go with the candidates who brought us into war. That would have never happened under Trump. And it's so crazy because he even says this party is unrecognizable. I mean, this party is at the feet of the government. They want government to control our bodies, control our lives, all these things. He's like, and truly, it's not the party of love and tolerance. It's the party of anti-free speech. You know, no, you don't get to choose what you do with your body and medical freedom. And it's unrecognizable anymore. And this is like, honestly, the party of communism now. So of course, the only thing that would make sense is for him to go and support Trump. And I will say, as a very pro-Trump person, we love everyone that's with RFK. We want the same things. We don't want forced vaccines and masks and lockdowns. And we want to have food and water that isn't poison. And we want medical freedom. And we don't want people's licenses being stripped away for free speech, which comes out, you know, 6 months later, they were right. So I believe if we join forces, it's the best thing we can do. I have nothing but love and respect for him and his followers, and we welcome them with open arms.
Emily Wilson, host of Emily Saves America, thank you so much for joining us on Power Hour. Great to speak with you.
Thank you so much. God bless.